Good morning students. In the previous section we have studied the colligative properties of dilute solution and their relationship with the molar mass of the solute. The different relation between colligative property and the molar mass are applicable only to the solution of the non-electrolyte, and it is based on a few of the assumption, and these assumption are the condition to get accurate molar mass, that is the solution should not be concentrated or it should be dilute, because if we are having concentrated solution, then because of the more amount of solute present on that, they aggregate together and form a cluster. Because of the formation of cluster, the molar mass of this one is going on increases. So it means here we do not get accurate molar mass, and there will be change in the molar mass takes place. Second, there will not be any type of association or dissociation of solute particle should takes place. It means because here we are talking about the solute and here we are calculating the molar mass of the solute. So if we are using electrolytes, so electrolyte, they may dissociate. So if the dissociation would takes place, then also there is change in molar mass takes place, or because of the change in molar mass, we do not get whatever the exact molar mass we have calculated. So to get the accurate molar mass, these are the two conditions that any of the solute into the solution should follow. Otherwise, when we measure colligative properties of electrolytic solution or the solution where the above assumption are not valid, so we find some type of difference in between the molar mass, that is observed molar mass and calculated molar mass value of colligative property, and it is given by one of the scientists called Tobias von Hoff. Before moving further, we have to see how does it takes place. Like if we have taken any of the solute, just take example, we have taken benzoic acid. So benzoic acid, because it has the tendency to form hydrogen bond, or because of the formation of hydrogen bonding, here we have benzoic acid. So molar mass of the benzoic acid is less, but as it goes into the solution, it form large molar mass, and then here there will be change in the molar mass takes place. It is the calculated molar mass that we are having at the time of solute, but in the solution start forming dimer. They combine with each other because of the hydrogen bond, and the formation of dimer takes place, and then there will be increase in the molar mass takes place, that is taken as the observed molar mass. Next, if dissociation of any of the molecule takes place, any of the solute molecule takes place, like here it is taken as An, which has more number of molar mass, which will give rise to on dissociating when we are putting it into the solution. On dissociation, it will give rise to A of N number, where the molar mass of this one is less as compared to the earlier one. So because of the association and dissociation, there is change in the molar mass takes place, or this association or dissociation is explained by one scientist, that is called as von Hoff, and here he has given one factor that is called as von Hoff factor. According to this scientist, he said that it is very difficult to calculate the accurate mass of any of the solute present in the solution, because whenever we are dissolving any of the solute, sometime it may happen, it may either associate or dissociate. So how could it is possible to calculate the accurate mass? So he has given one factor that is called as von Hoff factor, and it is denoted as I, small I, where I is equal to the observed value of colligative property upon normal value of colligative property. But here we know that colligative property are known to calculate the molar mass of the solute, where this molar mass is inversely proportional to the colligative property. If we are taking this molar mass in terms of colligative property, then it is equal to normal molar mass upon observed molar mass. With this way, we can calculate the change in molar mass of any of the colligative property. But if we are having solute, which it is not always necessary, then there will be dissociation or association takes place. If there is no association or dissociation takes place, thus the value of this factor, that is Van't Hoff factor, would always be equal to 1 if there will be no association or dissociation takes place. If association of any of the molecule takes place inside the solution, then here the value of Van't Hoff, that is I, will always be lesser than 1. And if the dissociation will takes place, then the Van't Hoff factor will always be greater than 1. So it means there is change in the molar mass takes place. So on the basis of above statement, all the colligative property can be little bit modified, because here in terms or according to the Van't Hoff, he said that there is change in formula. All the colligative property that we have done, that is relative lowering of vapor pressure, freezing point or elevation in boiling point or osmotic pressure, whatever the equation we have done earlier. So on the basis of Van't Hoff factor, there is little change. That is P naught minus Ps upon P naught, that is relative lowering of vapor pressure, will always be equal to XB, that is the mole fraction. But here according to the Van't Hoff, there is one more thing introduced, that is called to be as I, that is Van't Hoff factor. So whenever we are calculating on the basis of association or dissociation of the solute, which will be given in the question only, if it is asked in the question that association or dissociation of molecule takes place, then only you have to use this formula including I. If it is not given that any type of association or dissociation takes place, then there is no need to use this formula. Without using I, you can easily calculate the molar mass of any of the solute present in different type of colligative property. But if it is asked about the association and dissociation, then you have to do the little changes. Then for the elevation in boiling point, it is del Tb is equal to I Kb multiplied by molality. For depression in freezing point, it is del Tf is equal to I Kf M. And for osmotic pressure, pi is equal to I CRT, means everywhere you have to introduce I if association or dissociation is given in the question. So after that, because here we are talking about the dissociation and association, we know that degree of dissociation is represented as alpha, that already we have done in class 11. So if you have to calculate degree of dissociation or association, so first for the degree of association, it is denoted as alpha, which is equal to I minus 1, where I is the Van't Hoff factor, upon I divided by N minus 1, where N is the number of molecule associated or dissociated. Because here we are talking about the association, that's why this N is the number of molecule associated. Again, we will be taking example of benzoic acid. If we are having benzoic acid or any of the molecule which are having the tendency to make hydrogen bond, they always associate and then the formation of dimer takes place. So because they are going to form dimer, means two molecule combined together, so that's why in place of N here you have to write 2. For the degree of dissociation, alpha is equal to I minus 1 upon N minus 1. Again, I is the Van't Hoff factor, N is the number of molecule dissociated. Like if you are taking any of the electrolyte, that is NaCl. So NaCl, as you are putting NaCl into the solution, it dissociates and then the formation of Na plus and Cl minus takes place. Same if you are putting barium chloride, then it also dissociate and then formation of Ba2 plus plus 2 Cl minus. It means one barium and two chlorine is present into the solution. It means they are equal to 3. That's why here in place of N, the ions in which it is dissociated, that is 3. So here you have to use 3, and the value of I would be given in the question. So by this way you can calculate the degree of dissociation or association, which will help us to do the numericals. So with that, all the theoretical part of this chapter we have completed, but we are left with many of the numericals. Like we have to do the numericals on the basis of to calculate the concentration of solute into the solution, that is mass percentage, volume percentage, molarity, molality. These all we have to do. After that, we have to do the numericals on the basis of all the colligative properties. And then many more formulas we are having in this chapter that we have to do. But all the numericals we will start doing from the next class. Okay. Thank you, students.